Hey guys, in this video, we're going to go through apportionment using Webster's method. Webster's method is similar to Jefferson's method in that it uses a modified divisor. However, unlike Jefferson's method, with Webster's method, instead of forcing us to round down, we're going to follow standard rounding rules. As far as the modified divisor is concerned, this means that instead of requiring us to choose one that is smaller than the standard divisor, as we did with Jefferson's, we can choose a modified divisor that is either larger than or smaller than the standard divisor. So, as you can see, I have my Excel spreadsheet set up with the same example we've been doing for all the apportionment so far. Let's go back through calculating our standard divisor. So our standard divisor equals the total population divided by the number of seats to be apportioned. Once we have the standard divisor, we can use the standard divisor, which is here, to calculate the standard quotas, which will go here. Standard quotas are always equal to the individual population divided by that standard divisor. Now, because we want to drag this down, we need to anchor that standard divisor so it will not change when we move the formula. So there's my first standard quota, and if I take this formula and copy it down, then I have all of my standard quotas. Now, for the modified divisor, again, I can choose something larger than or smaller than my standard divisor. Since we did smaller for Jefferson's, let's try something larger for Webster's. Let's guess 800 to get us started. Now remember, you use a modified divisor, which I'll color code in green, to find modified quotas. And the formula is the same as the standard quotas. You take the individual state population and you divide it by that modified divisor, which again, we need to anchor by hitting F4 or by manually typing in those dollar signs. Once you have the first formula, again, you can drag that formula down and you have all of your modified quotas. Now, for Webster's method, you take the modified quotas and you do standard rounding rules. So we have to hit equals and we just type round because that's the name of the function in Excel. When you open your parentheses, it needs two things. Number one, it wants to know what number to round. So you click on the number beside it because that is the number we want it to round. You hit comma, and then the second thing it wants is how many places. So we want it to be a whole number, so we basically want zero decimal places, so you put in a zero, and then you can close those parentheses. And that did standard rounding rules. And then you can take that and round it for all of them. Now that we have the seats apportioned, the question is, did it work? Do we have all 30 seats that we're supposed to use divvied out to our different states? So let's sum up these seats and see if we hit 30. So sum, open parentheses, and highlight all of the ones we want to add, close the parentheses, and we've only used 28 seats. So it looks like our modified divisor of 800 was not appropriate. So now that we've used all cell references to do this work, if we change the modified divisor, it will automatically change the rest of our work. So let's try something closer to the standard divisor. How about we come down to 790? Well, as you can see, it changed the numbers and it got us closer to our 30. Now we have a total of 29 seats that are used. So it seems like we went in the correct direction. So let's step down again and try maybe 780. And there we have it. Using a modified divisor of 780 did give us 30 total seats used. So it looks like we found the correct modified divisor. So this is how you work through Webster's method for apportionment. We have one more apportionment video to go, so see you next time when we go through the Hill-Huntington method. Bye, guys.